Hey everyone, Alex here with Off the Cuff Reviews. I am back again with my lovely fiance, and we're going to be doing a special review for you. We're going to be doing a reaction, actually, for House of Gucci.
We've been waiting for this one.
Let's get into it.
Porto un maglione strano che piace a me. Con il maglione mi piace star, qui sui capelli che arrivano qui.
So we're watching House of Gucci and we're like halfway through and...
Okay, hang on. To be fair, unfortunately, this is the greatest Jared Leto role that we've got in a while. Joker?
I don't endorse that.
Joker?
I don't endorse that one, but okay, yes. But I don't understand this movie. I don't... What is this? This is like... They're playing like caricatures of the people, and Adam Driver literally looks like a character playing Adam Driver playing this
character. He just
looks
like he's standing outside of himself the whole movie. He just looks like he's just watching from behind himself, just... standing there, unfortunately, being a part of this movie.
And Lady Gaga. Also, their accents. The accents?
Okay, that's why I feel like this is his best. I don't know, just he's giving me Nicolas Cage vibes in this movie.
Yeah, but I feel like this is not what it needs. I don't know. I feel like we... Well, I mean...
Did I not tell you I was going into this thinking it was a comedy?
Yeah, but I don't think we're supposed to. Why would they do that? Like, why would they... This is like a serious... Like, they could have literally made this, like, good. Like, they could have just made it good.
Okay, hear me out. Ridley Scott didn't have to.
Yeah, why?
It just didn't have to.
The same guy that did The Last Duel?
In the same year?
What is this? Oh my god.
Like, that's the theme here.
Yeah.
Murder. Like, what is happening?
This is the worst.
A mess.
Yeah.
You go ahead.
You go ahead first.
Why?
Because I want to hear what you have to say.
I'm just really distraught about Jared Leto's character.
Because
in real life he died in poverty. That was so sad to find out. Because I really enjoyed that. I think Jared Leto was the highlight of this movie. He kept it funny and interesting. He was like the little comedic relief, I think.
Well, I disagree, but we do have like the same opinion about overall.
Yeah, overall this movie was a fucking trash fire.
Yeah, this is the worst thing I've seen all of last year, all of this year so far. It's like the worst.
It was easily 2 hours too long.
Yeah, it was every second was too long. The shots were bad. It was directed poorly. He was like zooming in and out like really quickly, and
the shots were shaky.
Yeah, shaky cam, not
like
good.
Me right now,
literally. But and the performances, every performance was awful. Everyone, like, not even one of them was good. I mean, I know you think Jared Leto was good. I don't like Jared Leto's character in this. I thought it was awful. I thought that they literally made every person a caricature,
yes,
of the actual real person.
Okay, thinking back on Adam Driver in Inside Llewellyn Davis, in Girls, in literally Star Wars, and then this?
He was like Adam Driver playing... He was like somebody playing Adam Driver playing this character.
Yeah, like I said, he kind of just felt like he was watching himself act,
yeah,
in this movie. And I don't know, it was like a shell of that. The cats hated the movie.
Oh my god. Yeah, it just sucks. It was just awful. It was a waste of time and money, and I don't understand why they...
I personally feel like Ridley Scott could have put out a better second movie this year.
He, after this, like, I don't want him directing anything. I will never watch a movie where Ridley Scott.
I was just about to be like, should we watch The Last Duel?
No, I don't know. I mean, people are saying it's good, but I don't really care. And I don't really, like, he just ruined it. He just put a bad taste in my mouth. Like, why even do any of that? You don't even need these kind of actors in it.
Yeah.
Have, like, Italian actors.
Yeah, like I said, we were talking, and I said they could have, like, with the accents, they didn't really have to go full-blown. I don't think it was so necessary, because we understand who they're playing. It's, like, we get it, and it, they could have, like, dulled down the accents a little bit, because it did feel a little bit, like, he was, like, this feels like a Saturday Night Live sketch, so... It, felt, really did.
It felt like they all had, like, a meeting as actors and were like, we're gonna ruin this movie. And then Ridley Scott was just, like, probably just, like, lost control of the production and was just like, we're just gonna fucking ruin it. Like, that's probably what
happened. We've wasted this much money.
Literally 75 million. We might as well
just commit. We've got a plane, bus. Almost as much as 100. Another bus. Oh, another bus. That was Lady Gaga that said that. Oh my God.
Yeah, I didn't even like Lady Gaga's character. I didn't.
No, I didn't like her at all in this movie.
I just don't understand. I thought the set design was awful. I thought, like, everything was just bad.
The fact that they shot on so many locations.
Yeah, and still made it look CGI. Like, why? Like, why would you do that? Like, it doesn't even look real.
Yeah, that was a mess.
It was, like, over digitized. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck? 75 million? That's where all of it went?
Is this going to be a running theme on your channel this year? Us just shitting on movies that everybody else liked?
If they give us bad movies, yeah.
I mean, but this movie I was going to say, this one did not get popular reviews, but Red Rocket?
Yeah, Red Rocket, yeah.
The Matrix?
Yeah, what? The Matrix? It was bad.
John Wick 4? What are you rating House of Gucci?
Honestly, I might not even rate it.
I'm gonna give it a good 1.5. And that 1.5 goes to Jared Leto's performance and Jared Leto's performance alone. And I am not a Jared Leto fan. I just realized he was the bad guy in Panic Room and I laughed about it. I'm not a fan.
I just don't understand why they made this at all. Yeah, fuck everything about this. It was bad. It was horrible.
Waste of money. Waste of set design.
This is a live reaction, by the way. Like, this is
we right just after. Finished the movie. Anna Wintour? Love her.
Okay, can we talk about the nose thing, or should we
oh my god, we're not talking about the nose thing. We're not talking about the nose thing.
Can we?
No.
Can we just mention it?
It's just Ashley just embarrassing herself constantly everywhere. I thought the blonde lady was wearing a fake nose. Jared Leto had a full face thing going on. It was not wrong of me. It looked like it was glued on. It wasn't. It was her real face.
I think it's because they over-digitized the everything. And it just made it look fake. Like, it made everything look fake. They were just like, let's make this look fake. And let's do acting that way too. For 75 million.
And the press for this movie, they acted so pretentious about it. They acted like they all had sticks up their asses because they did fucking House of Gucci. Let me tell you, Father Son House of Gucci. Does eat a dick. That's
the cringiest line of all time.
They probably said it in real life too, which is really sad.
They made them seem like
that right there. Hang on, that right there when he said like swear and like that's what she said. That's like when the Kardashians say Bible when they want to swear on something. Oh, that's what God. That reminded me of.
This movie was just bad on all fronts.
Well, in the name of the Father and the Son and the House of Gucci,
Karsten Runquist,
we're signing off. We're not gonna beat this dead horse today. we'll see you on the flip side. I had to think about where I was here.